And it's a nice morning today. Although it's supposed to give some heavy rain tomorrow, thunderstorms and all that jazz. What the hell? There's a sale on. Not much that I want to buy. But a lot of the stuff through it, when it was, last time there was a sale on. It was Easter time. Can you imagine? I mean, buying some of the stuff on here in sales, like 30, 40, 50% knocked off each Woco, whatever you want to buy. Sometimes as much as 60%. And still managing to rack up your costs. But never mind. Whew. Get some windows open today, it's a bit warm. Cherry and cinnamon infusion tea, whatever you want to call it, herbal tea. Cherry and cinnamon, very nice. So we shall get going. Really, really strange. I can't understand why, since moving into this flat, I seem to get more dust in this flat than I ever did in my other house. I don't get it. I'm forever cleaning it up. I never got this dusty when I lived in my old house. Unbelievable. Maybe it's because it's smaller property, maybe, I don't know. Who knows? Here we are. Oh, yes. Lovely jubbly. It's winter. It's snowing. And we are sat in Cleethorpes station. Ha ha. Ha ha. And this is what the loco we are driving. It is a B, Thompson B1. Which is the locos that they used a lot in Lincolnshire back in the day. Thompson, and we're hauling four. Hang on a minute. What are they? British Railways. So they are BRs. They are whatever you want to call them. Blood and custard. That's what we call them. Blood and custard. Or, well, I think that's what you call them anyway. Well, that's what a lot of people call them. Blood and custard coaches. Let's go around here. Cleethorpes. That's the brake van. That's your brake. That's the brake. Usually carries your parcels and stuff in there, I would have thought. And then you got coach one, no, coach three, coach two, coach one, British Railways. So British Railways, British Railways came in about 1948, I think it was, if I remember right, correct me if I'm wrong. When all the main four companies, like LNER, GWR, the separate companies merged together, I think it was 1948, and became British Railways. A lovely, and in them days you got proper snow. I don't hardly get any snow around here nowadays. Isn't it funny? Back in the day when there was all that snow, it didn't stop anything. And now you get a few millimetres of snow and it stops everything. Just too much bloody health and safety, that's what it is. We're speeding. How was that? Oh, we're changing tracks. Oh, 25 mile an hour ago, a minute ago. So we're going to be leaving Cleethorpes. We've left Cleethorpes. We're going to Scunthorpe. But it's not the station we now know. It's back in the days before in steam. So I'm presuming this is. This will be 1948, maybe after. The Scunthorpe station, what we now know it as, where all the trains stop now, was actually Frodingham station. And the old Scunthorpe station is the one where we're going to on this scenario is actually down the road. For anybody that knows Scunthorpe, if you basically come out of Scunthorpe station and walk down to the traffic lights on the station road and take a right onto High Street East, the buildings from the station are still there. I think you can see them from the station, but I wouldn't mind going and having a look, because you can access it. Somebody done a video on it about the old Scunthorpe station, and so yeah. And there is Grimsby Town Football Club. There's the Blundell Park, Grimsby Town's football club. Shall we stop at all the stations? Yeah, why not? So the first one is New Clee. We'll stop at New Clee. His total journey is going to be 38 miles, which nowadays is less than 30 miles now. So we'll stop at New Clee. Why has the sander been turned off? So this is New Clee on a nice snowy morning. Everybody get on. This is Wickham Road Bridge. That takes you down to the Ross Young's factories. There's the docks. Ivy Street Station, unused. Okay. Must have been in a long time before British Railways then. We're going to stop at the next station, Grimsby Docks. It's a bit laggy, it's not normally. Maybe it's because it's snowing. I don't know. Normally it's not this laggy. Let's stop at Grimsby Docks. I've never really driven this route when it's been winter. Grimsby Docks. And the sand has been took off again. I didn't... Oh well. Station should be Grimsby Town. Thank you. think that's the footbridge that takes you into Beeman Street. There's lots of people on it. I think it's people walking. Yeah, it is. It's the footbridge that takes you to over to Beeman Street. We got some wheel slip going on. Seems to be. Looks like we've got some wheel slip going on there. A little bit of wheel slip. Sander. We need to brake. Mph, yeah. Brake. And this is coming into Grimsby Town. So this level crossing that we're passing here, this will be Pasture Street, I believe. Yeah, it will be. Or it should be. Stop it in Grimsby Town. Grimsby. Was a shot. Yep. Well, I think. Let's check. Yeah, the shot. Miles an hour out of here. This is Friar Gate level crossing, which is the one what brings you up from the main road near the church on Bethlehem Street. Or it should be. Yeah, there should be some shops up here. up there, probably. I think we'll just go straight to Scunthorpe. I can't be bothered to stop at all the stations. Because it'll take forever. Nice and quiet at the back. Just reduce that down a bit, that's better. Too much power. Don't know how far that zooms out. Wow, that's quite a long way. So that is a river of some description. Coming through great coats in a minute. It's a 260. Next station is Healing and then Stallenbrough. the line speed, 60 here. I'm not sure, but I don't think there's a 20 mile an hour limit at Haber anymore. Oh, so I went through there on Sunday and he seemed to be a little quicker than 20, it seemed faster than 20 going into the Haber station. But I don't think there is a 20 mile an hour speed limit anymore at Haber. And here we're coming through Stalinbrough. I was going to say, we should have had some lights on really, it's not good weather. Roxton side in, level crossing. Foggy, can't see much. Tabor Station. What the hell? Normally we'd be going on the left hand track in the normal, in the present day, and be heading to Barnaby. This one doesn't. Survey. next station is Foughton Abbey, where the monastery is. Didn't even have to brake. Foughton Abbey. Then Goxhill. First class coach. Coxhill. avoiding New Orleans. Avoiding line. Barrahaven. the Barrow West Marsh Lane level crossing. All the ponds on the left. Right. Barton. Start to slow down for the 30. Barrow Willow Tree. Back the phone number. Straight through Barton. Tomorrow now in a minute. Barton Gravel Pit Lane. South Ferriby. Well, the Humber Bridge wasn't built in them days. South Ferriby's not far from there. We won't expect to see it. This is South Ferriby. Not a station I've been to very often on this route. There's the Ferriby, South Ferriby works, and there's the River Ancombe as it flows into the River Humber, Ferriby. Bingham Sluice. way. Slowing down as we're coming into wintering them. Go 10 miles an hour over a bridge in a minute. This is Winteringham Station. pretty much the same scenery on both sides. West Alton. Fulton Gate. Now we're coming into Winterton. Winterton station. We'll be passing Bagmore sidings in a minute. More side is dropping for you. Going up a hill. One in 50. One on one. No, one in 150. Thank you. going to Normanby Park. Normanby Park North Signal. Signal box, is it? Only 3 miles away from Scunthorpe. Crosby Mines. I think it's a 15 mile an hour through here, even though it doesn't show it. I might be wrong. No, it's not, it's 25. You usually stop here to get the token. There's the south signal box. That'll be a big road, that. Over there, where them cars are. Big road. Scunthorpe allotments. Less than a mile away now. Scunthorpe allotments. There's the engine sheds. just want to check something before we go in that station. Where are we? Oh yeah, there we are. There's a reversing point there. This is where the old Scunthorpe station used to be. It's a dead end. Let's have a look at that a minute. Where are we? Where's Scunthorpe State? Where's Foddingham? That's Scunthorpe Rowland Road. Is that a Foddingham? Oh, that's half of it. Foddingham Ironwork. Okay. Right, that's that one done then. Why is that a 101 on there? It's a 101, that's a 111. Lincolnshire poacher. Oh dear. Shall we do this one? A Robinson 04 emergency delivery ends in on a spad. Make a delivery to the villages of the harsh winter of 1947. Sugar beet factory, I don't think that one works. Right, we're going to do the emergency delivery. Robinson 04. So, what we got to do? This is the Robinson 04. When I turn it around, there it is. British Railways Robinson 04. Beautiful. It's in the Scunthorpe. Right. So let's have a look at this and see what we've got to do. 1947 and the worst winter on record, with the largest snowfalls being recorded in Lincolnshire. The villages to the north of Scunthorpe have been cut off by a road. Food supplies are running low. The North Lincolnshire Light Railway now comes into its own with a train to the rescue. A spare Robinson 02 has been steamed up and made ready for the arduous journey to Winterton, West Holton and Winteringham, with an unlikely train made up of brake vans. Why brake vans, you may ask? I have no idea. But it is historically accurate. There's not much time to waste, as yet more snow may fall, and the line may well get blocked. So after dropping off the brake vans, as required to each village station, empty coal wagons are to be returned to Scunthorpe. along with the new, now emptied brake vans left in the sidings, and the loco coaled up ready for tomorrow's roster. So, couple up to the back of the emergency train at Scunthorpe 1, stop at Normby Park signal box, drop off one at Winterton, one at West Alton, one at Winteringham, then couple up to the front of the emergency train at Winterton sidings 3. Winterton, West Alton sidings 2. Couple up that one at West Alton's, couple up that one, and then basically then drop them all off at Scunthorpe sidings 4. So first thing we've got to do is reverse this loco. Let's put some lights on. Reverse the loco into Scunthorpe station. There it is. Let's do it properly. Hang on, let's get into the right one. There we go. I can't see much on that. Okay. So let's go to Scunthorpe 1 and hook up these brake vans that we've got to take to people who were cut off. Not a very good view from the Thompson 04, is it? Like the locos, not the loco, the tender looks a bit wide. Okay, we'll do that then. Let's go hook up to our emergency train. Try not to crash into them. Must be on a hill here. No, it's not. Just say it's slowing down quite. Are we hooked up to him yet? No. Yeah, now. Okay, now we can go to Normanby Park signal box. Check signals. That's fine. What's this one like to look out of? Oh, that's not bad. Going to normal before the signal box. At least you get some windows to look out of. out the window. Oh, wrong side. So we've got Normanby Park signal box. How many brake vans is there? Yeah, oh, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 brake vans. And apparently this is historically accurate or something. This is what happened in 1947. You get a good view anyway if you're in the right seat. Now it's 25. So let's go to Normanby Park. North signal box is what we just passed not long ago when I was doing that Cleethorpes to Scunthorpe. Where's the signal coming up? Oh, it's there. Is it green? Yeah. Yeah, it's not a bad view. At least you got the windows at the front. You don't have to pop your head out of the window all the time. Freight train on the right hand side there. Train coming on the other side as well. Don't know what this is. It's another freight train. No, they're just ground signals. Up the pace a little bit more. I don't think the Robinson rode 4 out of speedo, did it? Probably not. No, I wouldn't have thought so. Got another train coming past. More ground signals, although it's okay, they're all ground signals. two locos on their sidings. Get a couple of locos there. Speeding. Coming up to Nombi Park signal box now. We've got to stop here. We'll cut the power and we'll begin to slow down. Perfect. Right, wait here. Let's have a look on the other side. There's a signal box on the other side. Now go to Winterton 1. So we've got to go drop off 731766, which will be, oh hang on, 731766. Where's that? That one? How are we going to drop that off? It's in the middle. Don't make sense. Check that again. It says drop off 731766 at Winterton. What's that one? Drop off 730898. At the next station. That one. And then 554. Let's reduce the power. 554. 554 is not even there. Have we not picked them all up? 554 is not even on here. Maybe I shouldn't have got those. Don't know. Seems strange. There's a hill coming up. Ah. I'm dropping off these three. And then couple up there. Alright, okay, yeah. 730870. Yeah. Alright, we'll worry about that when we get there. Emergency supplies. Robert Snowfall is a 280. Didn't know that. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 bait bands. So I'm presuming we're dropping three off at one place, one off at another, one off at another. And then, I don't know what happens after that, we'll find out. Pick some speed up. So we're coming into Winterton in less than a mile. Brake vans. Right, we should think about slowing down in a minute. Into Winterton Station. Here we are at Winterston Station. Put some brakes on. So we're going to stop here. And then we've got to uncouple. Seven three one seven six six. Okay. That done. Now we'll go to West Alton and drop off 730898. Yep. So that's them dropped off, and we put the brakes on them just so they don't roll away. I think the people are going up there now to unload it. West Alton, less than a mile. Okay then, let's go to West Alton. And we shall drop this one off, which is that one, in West Alton. And RHQ 730, but that one there is going to Winteringham. Slightly down now. Let's cut the power. Right, here's Winteringham, so let's cut the power and start thinking about breaking into the station. We'll slow down on our own until we get to the platform. And then we shall drop off the back one, which is that big one there. What the hell happened there? We derailed. How can we derail? That's not good. Hey, how can we derail? Are you joking, aren't you? Click here to go back to main menu. Why do we derail? Where is it derailed then? was the point set against us? How come the point's been set against us? Well, that was a bummer. Can't we reverse? Might be able to get it back on the track. No, we can't reverse. Continue. Well, what the fuck went on there? Well, that's good, isn't it? The train's derailing. Ain't got time to restart it. I've got to go to work soon. In fact, you know, I ain't got time to restart it. We'll attempt it later. Well, this time we'll have a look at that. There's a point needs resetting somewhere. That's strange. How it just derailed. I'm trying to see where. Yeah. Is it a manual point, sir? Don't know. Well, they ain't getting their... they ain't getting their van, are they? That's why we've just got to be way off some reason. Oh dear. I want to see why. I want to check that out.